New in Continuum FCP 2022 is the Academy Award-winning Mocha Masking and Tracking. It's included with every BCC Plus effect. Now, Mocha gives FCP editors the ability to add extra production value to your projects with minimal time spent, all from its legendary and proprietary planar tracking technology. In this video, let's take a look at how we can access Mocha Masks, as well as how to differentiate it from other tools available to us inside of Final Cut Pro. Now, if you're new to Mocha, you should know at its core, it's a planar tracker. This means it's designed to track a pattern of pixels or a texture moving in one direction. Now, if we compare that to the object tracker in Final Cut Pro, you should know that it also allows you to create more complicated masks. It offers extreme flexibility with manipulating track and shape data, can easily handle occlusions and perform offset tracks, and also remove areas from inside a mask. Mocha is also GPU accelerated and designed to take advantage of your M1 chips. So accessing Mocha is easy in Final Cut. Let's start off by going to the effects browser. I want to head to the BCC film style category, where I'll apply BCC Plus looks to this clip. You should know that this one effect is free. Simply head to borisfx.com and download it today. It also includes Mocha. I'm going to click on the inspector with my clip selected. And let's head to the effects editor to first of all apply a preset to this clip. I can see here on the left-hand side all of the available presets ready to go. And if I click on one, it is applied to the clip. I'll press apply, and now it's inside my Final Cut host. Since I want to limit this effect to be everywhere except inside his visor, I'll use Mocha for this. And you'll note that this isn't an actual shape that's available in Final Cut to get precise, such as a square or an oval. Okay, to enter Mocha, I want to click on the Mocha Mask button, and you should see that you're inside the Essential workspace. Now, the first thing for us to do is to use our tools at the top to define a shape or region which we would like to see the effect or not see the effect. We have several tools that we can choose from for creating shapes, such as the Very Flexible X-Spline tool, a magnetic layer tool, which is great for contours and edges, as well as some simple shapes here for rectangle as well as elliptical shapes. We can also use the hand tool and zoom tool for moving and panning around our image. I'll select the X-spline tool for now. And one cool thing is that you can temporarily activate the hand and the pan tool. So if I hold down Z, temporarily activates the zoom tool and I can zoom in here on the image. I'll start to create the X-spline. So I'm going to click to make a point and then click to make another point. I'm just going to draw around this visor until I fill it out. And then I'm going to go back to my first point and double click to close out the shape. And if I draw your attention to the left, you can see a layer was created, which we can double click and we'll call it Track Visor. If we select a point and then press Command A, we can get all of our points selected here. And if you drag out, you make those points rigid. And if you drag inward, you're gonna make them more rounded. At any point, you can also click off, always select the layer, and make adjustments or tweaks to be even more precise with that shape. I'm gonna press Z and hold down so we can zoom out on the actual image. And how we'll be tracking this image is located down here in the Essential tab. We can track translation, that's position data, scale, rotation, skew, and perspective. In this particular image, there's a lot of position, scale, and rotation movement. So I'm gonna click off skew just to not have it involved with the track. Noticing where my playhead is, I'm gonna start to track backward and let's just see what happens to the shape. By default, it seems to be holding on fairly well, but as the subject begins to turn his head, we can see that part of his visor wasn't included in this mask. Now, I'm gonna move my playhead since the track is done to that frame where we can see this occur. One of the most magical things about Mocha is because it keeps its tracking and shape data separate, I can adjust the shape and Mocha is going to interpolate between this adjustment and the original frame that I created the mask on. So let me first of all press the Z key to zoom in on this shape. Let's first of all select these points here at the top just to adjust them slightly on the visor. And then I'm going to select all these points here at the side by clicking and dragging to make a marquee selection, and then drag over to the side in order to tighten up this shape. And now that I've made that adjustment, I just want to now move in between the original mask shape that I had and the changes here. And you can see it makes the transition between those two points. Now, if need be, we could perfect this on other frames to get this mask just right. I'll now move my playhead all the way to the beginning to check out if I need to make any other adjustments, but it's looking pretty good. And now I'll move back to my original first point I created. Press the Z key to zoom out, followed by the X key holding that down to pan. And let's now track forward. And while we track forward, I'm going to turn something on temporarily. I'm going to turn on this S icon, as well as this plane to show you what's called the surface track. So this is the actual mathematical data that Mocha is coming up with as you track. It's the planar surface. Essentially, this isn't just one plane because there is reflections here. But in this particular example, Mocha is doing a really good job of tracking this surface. Now, the magical part about this planar surface is even after the track, if I made an adjustment, here I can adjust planar surface tool, and you'll see that it just adapts to what we tracked. I'll turn off that planar surface tool, and we still need to make some adjustments here to the side of the mask. So I'll drag around all of those points and then bring this in and then make some adjustments at the top of the visor and see a green line created here. It now adjusts based on that change that I made. In order to get back to Final Cut, we simply click on the X icon at the top left of the interface. And if I press save, you can see here that the effect is now limited to the visor. And all of that tracked information carries over. Since we want the exact opposite, what I'm going to do is enter into Pixel Chooser, which happens to be under the Mocha mask. And if we look under the mask section, we can see that Mocha spline is currently selected. We have an option to invert this. So if I click on this now, everything is on the outside of the visor. I'll also add just a little bit of a feather, not too much because the mask shape is so tight, and then just enter into full screen mode so we can see that completed track. Done with a more complicated shape than we can create in Final Cut, not to mention what we can manipulate with ease by having Mocha interpolate between any changes that we made to the mask. Now, what else can we do with Mocha to get even more production value from it? In this example, we want to change the color of this car here as the camera pans out. And we want to make sure that the color doesn't affect the back and the front windshield. To achieve this, I've already done a search for color, and I'll apply the very simple color paste effect. Here, let's define our color in the inspector to be a purple color, followed by clicking on the Mocha mask button. I'm going to press the Z key and hold that down just to zoom in on the image so we get closer to the car. And now we're going to define a region to track. And it's not going to be the complex car to begin with. I'll just grab this simple square shape and try to select a plane. In this case, the pavement, the shadow, as well as the grass all seem to be on the same plane, as well as offer quite a bit of texture, which should work well with this track. In order to see the surface, I'll turn on the planar surface tool with the S and the grid, and we can adjust this, of course, just to visualize how the plane should look. I'll press the Z key and then click and hold with my mouse to zoom out. And now let's change the name of this layer, track data, and under essentials, we're going to just track translation and scale. So I'll click on scale once and again to avoid any rotation, skew, and perspective. Now that this is set up, I'm going to click on the track backward button. We can see there with our planar surface tool that Mocha seems to be doing a good job. And now that this track is successful, I'll move to the first frame I tracked, represented by this green arrow, and then click on the track forward button. And now previewing this, we have a successful track of our surface. Now it's time to attach a more complex shape to it. So I'll just turn off the planar surface for the time being. So now we're just seeing the shape. And I will now grab the X-spline tool. I'll click and hold with the Z key just to zoom in and draw a complex shape around the car. I double click to close the first point. I'll press Command A just to select everything and just drag a little bit inward. I'll click off and make any final adjustments here close to the car. And let's rename this layer. I'll double click it, calling it car. And the most important thing is to now take this shape we just created and attach it to the track data. In the Essentials tab, under Link to Track, let's switch that from car to track data. I want you to notice that the gear icon turned off for the car shape layer that we just drew. And most importantly, if I click and drag the playhead, it keeps up with that tracked information. Again, if we need to, we can make adjustments to the shape if it, for any reason, falls off, or we determine that we need to make additional adjustments, and it will interpolate between that and the first point that we created. Now that we've defined the region that we want to limit the color to, let's now start to define the regions where we don't want the color to show up, which is the front and back windshield. To do this, we're just going to create some more shapes. To use something we haven't seen before, I'm going to select the magnetic spline tool and click and use it to track around the edges of that front windshield. It's made its shape. I might want to come in here and just make some adjustments. I'll press Command A to select all the points and just drag to make this a bit more curved inward. Let's rename it Front Windshield, and then under Essentials, link it to the track data. I'll repeat this one more time by selecting the Magnetic Spline tool again and defining the back windshield. New shape is created after clicking on the first point. I'll adjust to perfect the mask, name this new layer Back Windshield, and then link this to the track data. If I play this back, both the front and back windshield are linked. And again, we can make any adjustments as necessary to make sure that area is defined. Now we need to make a few final changes before going back into Final Cut. I'll press Z to zoom out our entire image. Most importantly is to change the blend mode for both of our masks of the windshields. To do this, we'll go under Layer Properties, where we'll change the blend mode from Add, being added to the mask, to Subtract. So it's going to leave out this area. I'll repeat that for the front windshield under Layer Properties, Subtract. And last but not least, we don't need the track data that we have here. We don't want this to act as a mask, so I'll turn off that layer by clicking on the eye switch. Here's the car set to an add blend mode and attached to our track data. And then the front and back windshield also attached to the track data, but at a subtract blend mode for its masks. And if I click the X icon to leave out of Mocha and choose save, heading back into Final Cut, you'll see that that color is indeed limited to the car, although a little bit strong. Under the color paste effect, I'll just bring down the mix value of that to about 50%, move my playhead to the beginning of the timeline, and then go into full screen playback so we can see how this limited color has turned out on our car here. Awesome. So as you can see, Mocha Masking offers you an incredible amount of control to help your effects workflows to the next level in Final Cut Pro. In this movie, we learned how we could access Mocha Masks under any BCC Plus effect, how we could then draw complicated masks, as well as track them with ease using translation, scale, rotation, and even skew and perspective data. We saw how we could then grab onto that information inside of Final Cut, reverse the direction of our mask, and even use subtractive masks in our workflow for areas where we didn't want the effect to show up in an already defined mask region. There's a lot to Mocha, and we're going to continue to put out information as the weeks go along, so you become more familiar with this incredibly versatile tool in Continuum FCP 2022. Don't forget to click that subscribe button and check out some of our other videos on the Boris Effects channel.